Good morning, dear children. Yesterday we started with the Vedic civilization question answers. I finished name the following, right or wrong, answer in one word, again name the following. Today we'll go for answer in short, part 2. Just here, answer in short, what foods were included in the diet of the Vedic period? What foods were included in the diet of the Vedic people? So here you write first point, barley and rice were the staple food of the Vedic people. Second point, the diet was also milk, yogurt, ghee, fruits, cereals and meat. I'll repeat the answer again. Barley and rice were the staple food of the Vedic people. The diet also included milk, yogurt, ghee, fruits, cereals and meats. Second question, why were cows prized highly? Milk and milk products were imported items of the diet of the Vedic people. Milk and milk products were important items of the diet of the Vedic people. Second point, cow was a means, or you can write commodity of exchange. That means they used to exchange the goods. So therefore, cows were highly prized. Cow was a means or commodity of exchange, therefore cows were highly prized. Third question, what was a man accepted to do in the sannyas ashram? What was he accepted to do in the sannyas ashram? Sannyas ashram was the fourth and the last stage in the life of the man. Sannyas ashram was the fourth and the last stage in the life of the man. At this stage, man was accepted to sever all worldly relations. At this stage, man was accepted to sever all worldly relations and spend his time in meditation by the way going away to the forest. I'll read the answer again. Sannyas ashram was the fourth and the last stage in the life of the man. At this stage, man was accepted to sever all worldly relations and spend his time in meditations by going away to the forest. Next, let us write notes on. First one, the religious ideas during the Vedic period. So what were the ideas during the Vedic period? The Vedic people offered prayers to the forces in nature, such as the sun, the man. So the Vedic people offered prayers to the forest in the nature, such as the sun, the rain, the rivers, lightning and storms to get the blessings. Second point, they made ritual offerings in the fire to secure favor from the forces in nature. Third point, the ritual offering of Havi into the fire was called Yajna. Fourth point, the Vedic people believe that all the things in nature follow Rita. That is the definite pattern. Next point, they believe that the religion means to follow the rules of nature, as the violation thereof leads to natural calamities. I'll repeat the answer again. The religious ideas during the Vedic period. The Vedic people offered prayers to the forest forces in nature. Which were the forces? That is the sun, the rain, the rivers, lightning and storms to secure the blessings. Second point, they made ritual offerings to the fire to secure favor from the forces in nature. Third point, the ritual offering of Havi into the fire was called Yajna. Fourth point, the Vedic people believe that all the things in nature follow Rita. That is a definite pattern. They believe that religion means to follow the rules of nature, as many violation thereof leads to natural calamities. Second question, houses in the Vedic period. How were the houses? So most people live in the houses of mud and wattle and daub. Most of the people live in the houses of mud, wattle and daub means the shen, kobar lagake. The walls and the floors were plastered with mud and cow dung. The walls and the floors were plastered with the mud as well as cow dung. Third point, they call the place of dwelling as griha or shala. the place of dwelling, that means the place of the living, were called as griha or shana. Third question, political system in the Vedic period. First point, Gramani was a village headman. Second point, Vishpati headed Vish, that is a group of villages. Third point, a number of Vish constituted Janapad. Fourth point, Nripa was the head of the Janapad. Fifth point, the king appointed a number of officials to assist him in state administration. Senapati and Purohit were the most important officials of the king. Bhagduk has appointed to collect revenue. Sabha, Samiti, Vidhat and Jana deliberated on state affairs and provided guidance to the king. I'll read the answer again. Political system in the Vedic period. Gramani was a village headman. Vishpati, that is a group of the villages. A number of Vish constituted Janapad. Nripa was the head of the Janapad. The king appointed a number of officials to assist him in the state administration. Senapati and Purohit were the most important officials of the king. Bhagduk has appointed to collect the revenue. Sabha, Samiti, Vidhat and Jana deliberated on state affairs and provided guidance to the king. So, my dear children, I've completed the fourth chapter question answers. If you have written, you please check it. And there's some activity given over here. If you can do it, you please do it. Interview some artisans in your locality and write down about them, or list the new words in the lesson and find their meaning. You can do this activity. My dear children, as per the question answers going on, you write it. If you have written, you just check it. And if you have problem, please write it and keep it, my dear children. We'll solve it afterwards. Thank you. Have a great day.